Now, most of all is physical courage. If you are a policeman or a fireman, you need a lot of physical courage. Not afraid of getting hurt, okay? But some jobs don't require that much. You also need social courage. It's not afraid being alone, not afraid meeting new people, not afraid of rejection, not afraid of being different. Now this is something I had to learn, because a lot of experience show that if you are the only person in a group that's different, you are really automatically feel insecure. But when you're different, you're the only white in all black school, or only black in all white classes, or only male in all female group, or only female in all male group. Being the visible minority, okay, automatically you feel anxious, feel insecure. And we have to be able to say, well, being different is okay. You need courage. I'm different. My skin looks different. My costume looks different. So what? The world is made up of different people, right? So we need social courage to combat social anxiety. Now, this is also an important part, is that moral courage. How many people have the courage to tell the truth? Sometimes you might get fired. I'm getting in trouble all the time because I tell you that it is. That doesn't prevent me from speaking the truth. Okay. If I see something is not quite right, I speak up, right? Then you get in trouble. And people don't like troublemakers. But it takes troublemakers to make the world improve. So don't be afraid to speak the truth, right? Tell courage, action courage, trust courage at the workplace. Now, tell courage means tell truth. Now, action courage means the courage to do something even though you might fail. For young people start out working, or for middle-aged people, or for retired people, trust only you. Like, for example, now, he's not afraid of trusting on you in her retirement, right? Start a new career. Many people have three or four careers, you know, in a lifetime. You only prepare for failure before you succeed. But if you are afraid of failure, then fail for sure. So that's simple, right? You fail with action, no action, means you fail for sure. If you start something, not afraid of failure, then eventually you succeed. Remember what's the name, the one who invented electricity? Edison, yeah. He said, I failed a thousand times. Yeah. So there you are. And trust courage. This comes with leadership. Often we have a problem trusting other people, especially for self-made person. So it's difficult to work for a self-made person. You know why? Because self-made persons, they must have exceptional ability, exceptional habit of working hard. So their employee can never measure up with that, right? So therefore, they don't trust anyone. But nobody can work as hard as they are, right? So they don't trust anyone. That's one part, level control, okay? The other part is that I mentioned earlier, that trust people who are less competent than you are, entrepreneurs, self-made men, okay? Because they are able to succeed because they sacrifice so much to get there, the entrepreneurs, okay? When people work for them, might not have the same drive, same willingness to sacrifice. So they don't trust them. So that's why it's difficult to work for a self-made man, because the expectation is of you is so high. But you can never measure up to that. So they didn't have courage to accept that people are different, right? The employee do not have the same passion, same spirit of sacrifice, right? You can't expect that from anybody, right? Now create your courage. You know, why create your courage? Why you need courage to create something new? It it doesn't matter whether it's in politics or in art or in science. When you create anything new, what happens? You offend the establishment. When you present a new idea, it never goes well with the establishment because they will get there already. Mm-hmm. Who are you to present a new? So if you present new ideas, you have to be willing to undo criticism, rejection. I think Gandhi said that the first they ignore you and then they attack you. And when you eventually got more recognition, then slowly they say they claim your success. They ignore you, they attack you. Then when you're successful, they absorb you. This is what happened. It's small business. Like in the early days of Microsoft, they attacked small business, small competitor. When they're really successful, they buy them out. Mm-hmm. They happen. Nowadays, even. Big fish always try to crush the small ones. But when they're unable to crush them, they buy them out. That's what happened. So you're a creative guy, you have to be prepared for that, right? That people will attack you, ignore you, and then will buy you off. Extend your courage. The courage to be and to become what you are, right? Four types of extended courage. Listen to that. To grow up is painful. Make changes is painful. But what is most painful? Being stuck where you are. That's more painful because you're doomed. You're doomed to be miserable. You're stuck where you are. That's why I always tell my client, I say, when change is painful, become a better person is painful. But nothing is more painful than being stuck at where you are and not making change. You for sure you'll be miserable for the rest of your life. And you seek professional help because you want to improve, right? Too hard. Okay, then you stay where you are. Your choice, right? It's too hard, then you stay where you are. You're miserable for the rest of your life. So, an inquiry is to face the inevitable suffering. Now, I have an ongoing battle with my friends in positive psychology. It's a hit battle, okay? Hit a battle. Every time I mention suffering, I'm bringing suffering, they got mad, okay? See, in their thinking, you need to focus on the positive, okay? What is good, okay? It's better to focus on the positive than focus on the negative. But here's one problem. If you only focus on the positive, then you become very vulnerable when bad things happen, because you're not prepared. To be forewarned is to be prepared, right? You were saying that life is good, the world is safe, everything, life to be happy. That's what my argument is about positive education, okay? You will educate the kids, right now, positive education for two things. One is to be happy. The second thing is do what you're good at. It's all good. But often, at the first level, entry level jobs, you cannot tell your boss. I have one person actually told me that she only wants to do certain things that she likes. Nobody will hire you, right? You can't only do the things that you like. Imagine young people told, be happy, do the things you're good at, you never get a job. It's not reality, right? So real positive education means that you teach people to accept reality. That, of course, they're best find jobs that make use of your strength. But at entry level, you have to make a living, right? You have to take anything. You cannot be choosy, right? And also, if you think that, life is good, you're not prepared for the unexpected hard reality. Reality is very hard. So that's why my way of thinking in positive education, it teaches people to have courage to face reality. Reality means that life is full of suffering and full of blessings, full of opportunities. You only focus on that one opportunity, no suffering, then you are an unrealistic expectation. We don't prepare you for resilience, for survival, right? And also the courage to pursue your dream. Now here's the thing. You gotta say, I want to pursue my dream to do what I like most. You gotta demand that. To be able to pursue your dream, you have to maybe pursue it on the side. Maybe pursue it part-time. Maybe pursue it after many failures. You gotta say, I want to have my dream from the very beginning. It's not possible, right? Unless you're privileged, have a rich parents that give you everything. But most people have struggled their own. Spiritual courage, okay? Now, here's one way to increase your courage. Try to do something you're afraid of. You're afraid of writing, force yourself to do writing every day. The only way to overcome your fear of writing is to do right. William James said the same thing, the father of psychology, William James, remember William James? He said, every day do something that you don't like. If you form the habit of doing something you don't like, you're more likely to succeed in life than you only do the thing you like. Do you know why? If you only want to do the thing you like, then you avoid the thing you don't like. Sometimes it's a part of your job. You know, every job has negative part and part of that. There isn't a perfect job, then no downside. Every job, part of side, and negative side. You see that I only do the thing I like, and you don't like the thing you don't like, you don't do the thing you don't like to do, that can really hinder your career. Have you done it yet? No, I'm too busy. No, not too busy. But you don't like it. You do a lot of things you like, right? Your time to do other things, you say you have time to do the thing you don't like. The whole idea is that if you want to have courage, then do something you don't like. And also face something you're afraid. In logotherapy, it's called paradoxical intention. You want to overcome some fear, you intentionally face it. When you intentionally face it, then whatever you fear becomes less fearful. Mm.
Sure.
Yeah. So it's paradoxical, right? If you do the thing you don't like, then gradually you say, oh, I'm able to do it. Then you like it. But you're able to face what you're afraid of, because you can't forget that what I'm afraid of is a paper tiger. Mm. It's not scary. Right? Now, another way to overcome fear. Do you know that a mother will fight with a wild animal, a tiger or a wolf, to protect a daughter?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Why is a mother not afraid? They're not afraid because the daughter's life is more important. They're willing to sacrifice themselves. So therefore, you're not afraid when you realize that you're doing something meaningful. I remember I watched a video where the lion coming to attack the baby deer. Guess what the mother deer do? The mother deer surrender herself, stand still, let the lion eat her, so the baby deer can't escape. The mother deer just stopped running, just stand there. Please run. Just stand there and let the lion attack her. Frankl said something very insightful. Frankl said, despair equals suffering minus meaning. Despair or depression, whatever, or hopelessness, equal suffering minus meaning. So you have no meaning, you're in trouble, you have no meaning, then you suffer, okay? But you realize that you're suffering for something meaningful, that is no longer a suffering. It becomes a loving sacrifice for someone, for God, or for your children, or for something of value, right? So if you're able to see the meaning behind it, then your suffering cease to be suffering. It becomes a loving sacrifice for something of value, for your country, for your parents, and for God, for humanity, or whatever, for a larger cause.